this episode of the series, Cutting Edge looks at the classification issues surrounding Ron Howard's 1988 fantasy film Willow, which was first released on May the 20th of that year. Although it received mixed critical reviews, it has since become a cult film among fans of fantasy pictures. Willow received an uncut PG rating in the United States, and less than a week before it opened there, it was seen by the BBFC in the UK for the first time on May the 17th, 1988. UIP, the distributor, had requested a PG rating for the film's British release. Some examiners felt that the film's content was at U level for the most part, a category equivalent to the US G rating, meaning a film is suitable for all audiences. However, comments were also made that the levels of violence and fantasy horror towards the end of the film were problematic. As one examiner wrote in their viewing report,
PG is clearly the right category. A few problems do arise, however, particularly towards the end, with the last two reels becoming a very powerful and seemingly non-stop crescendo of battles, magic, monsters and violence.
The examiner report continued, stating,
throughout Reel 6, and to some extent in Reel 5, there is continuous minor league violence, with throats cut, arrows in chests, daggers landing in bodies, etc. Rarely do we see significant process or after effect, but there is a build-up of violent images, very much at top end of PG, and on one or two occasions, shots do slide towards 15.
It is worth remembering that the BBFC had not yet introduced the 12 rating for cinema releases, which was just over a year away, so there was an unusually large gap between the PG and 15 ratings. The examiner also noted some comic sex references, and the sight of what appeared to be a medieval version of a shuriken or ninja star. In the 1980s, these weapons were routinely cut from films in Britain under BBFC director James Furman's weapons policy, regardless of a film's rating. But in Willow, the examiner noted that,
in this sort of context, it is less worrying than elsewhere, perhaps.
After some discussion at the BBFC, the board outlined a list of changes to UIP that would help them secure their desired PG rating, which included reducing some fantasy horror elements, the desaturating of reds to soften the sight of blood on characters' faces during battle scenes, and the reduction in volume of violent sound effects in the last two reels of the picture. After these cuts had been made, the BBFC held a test screening on the evening of October the 5th, 1988, for children aged between 7 and 12 who attended with their parents. Such test screenings were occasionally undertaken by the BBFC in the days before the board conducted public consultation to help shape their classification guidelines. Following this screening, the young audience was asked to fill in a questionnaire about the film, and after reading some of the comments, the BBFC's director James Furman felt that the changes the board had demanded of UIP had not quite gone far enough to secure a PG. As a result, the day after the screening, Furman wrote a letter to the filmmakers to explain the situation, the contents of which we have summarized here.
I think the cuts worked very well, particularly the softening of the soundtrack in the last two reels. I have to say that the regrading of color in the bloody combat scenes did not go as far as I had hoped, but it seemed to be a bit better than the original. I didn't ask for a similar treatment of the blood on Brazel's face at the end of the battle with the Queen, but on the questionnaire, a lot of the kids commented on her blood-streaked face as among the things they didn't like, so if it can be toned down a bit, it would help. Most of the kids found the beginning very frightening indeed. I am sorry, I did not realize just how horrific the two wild boar taken by the kids as dogs would seem. After the midwife pushes the baby downstream, the camera lets us see the dogs attack and apparently kill the midwife. The kids found this very horrible indeed. It was deeply unsettling. Isn't the death of the midwife taking this kind of thing a bit too far? I hope Ron Howard can have his editors look at this to see if we can lose the whole idea that the dogs attack and savagely kill the good midwife who has just saved the baby. with the removal of those shots in the opening credits and some reduction in the redness of blood on Rizel's face in the final scenes of Reel 6, we will be able to give you the PG.
So, let's look at all the combined changes made to Willow for its British theatrical release in chronological order. In the following comparisons, the censored scenes in the British version have been lifted from two digitally captured VHS master tapes that match the UK cinema version of the film. Although these clips are presented in pan and scan, they should give a general idea of the cuts made for the original widescreen theatrical release of Willow in the UK. The first cuts occurred in Reel 1 of the film, during the sequence where the midwife floats baby Alora away to safety. The sequence in the uncut version plays as follows. For a PG rating in Britain, the BBFC demanded...
In title sequence, remove all sight of dogs attacking midwife after she has floated baby downstream, remixing sound to remove dog attack noises.
The UK version includes some unique footage here, including a new shot of the midwife running away to safety, as well as an additional shot of Alora that is not present in the uncut version in order to smooth over the cuts. The changes are well implemented, as this clip demonstrates. Willow was left unscathed until Reel 5, where the BBFC demanded two more changes, the first of which affected the scene of Willow casting a spell on the troll that threatens him. The uncut version of the scene follows. For a British PG, the BBFC cuts list stated,
reduce scene of troll turning into two-headed dragon by removing all sight of troll peeling back furry scalp to reveal brain.
Approximately 10 minutes later, another sequence was affected. The material in the uncut version plays thus. Watch closely.
Come for Alora Dannon.
You dare to challenge me? You're not warriors. You're pigs.
Mother, no!
For the UK, the BBFC demanded
considerably reduced scene in which Queen Bavmorda transforms Mad Martican and soldiers into pigs, removing profile shot of Mad Martican's partially transformed face and minimizing Sorsha's pleas to her mother and shots of soldiers writhing around in agony, together with agonized pig squeals on soundtrack.
The censored UK version played as follows, removing a shot of what is assumed to be Mad Martican almost fully transformed, along with the extended sight of Sorsha falling to the ground in pain as men squeal around her.
Come for Alora Dannon!
You dare to challenge me? You're not warriors! You're pigs! Mother, no! Jordan!
Reel 6 saw the heaviest changes in Britain, which affected the sound effects levels in numerous violent sequences in the finale. It would be tedious to demonstrate every individual sound cut made here, but this small clip shows a brief example of the sound effects levels in the uncut version. Listen closely. For Reel 6, the BBFC made two particular demands to the filmmakers.
Reduce violence of soundtrack throughout battle scenes, emphasizing music instead, and in particular, remove sound of throat cutting as Eric kills soldier guarding boiling oil.
This BBFC change resulted in the reduction in volume of numerous punches, body blows, and slashes with swords in many of the fight sequences. Again, this small clip from the cut version demonstrates just a handful of the sound effect reductions made for the UK cinema version, including the aforementioned throat cutting. Listen carefully. The next affected sequence in the UK cinema version was the fight between Eric and Kale, which plays as follows in the uncut version. Here, the BBFC demanded
reduce violence of fight between Eric and Kale by removing shot of Eric jerking back as he is stabbed in abdomen, reducing some of the redness of blood on Eric's face, reducing violent fight effects on soundtrack.
The reduction in redness of blood was achieved by optically desaturating the redness in the film slightly. Although this is not as clear on VHS as it would have been on film, the cut British PG version played as follows. Similar cuts to Bloody Detail were implemented for the two fights between Mad Martigan and Kale. We have edited the footage down for clarity here, but the affected material in the uncut version played thus. For a PG rating, the BBFC demanded
reduce bloodiness of both fights between Mad Martigan and Kale by removing sight of Mad Martigan with blood on his neck and reducing sight of bloody gash in Kale's face when mask is sliced away, and of Mad Martigan's bloody nose. Also reduce intensity of redness of facial blood through regrading color. Considerably reduce violence of final fight on bridge between Mad Martigan and Kale by removing sight of Mad Martigan slamming his hand against hilt of sword embedded in Kale's abdomen, and sight of Kale being pulled slowly down to be impaled on angled sword.
With these changes made, the affected material in the cut UK cinema version played as follows. Immediately after this, the final BBFC cuts for Willow were demanded. The uncut version contains the following material, which we have again edited for clarity.
My old disappearing pig trick. Well done!
In Britain, the BBFC cuts list stated,
reduce fight between good and bad witches by removing first two heavy punches by Rizelle to Bavmorda's nose. Also reduce sight of Bavmorda strangling Rizelle, and reduce redness of bloody scratches on Rizelle's face during and after climax of fight.
With these changes made, an example of the affected material in the cut version plays as follows.
My old disappearing pig trick.
Well done! Now off good, receive this book of magic.
Following the initial round of BBFC cuts, and the further changes they requested following the test screening in early October 1988, Willow was passed by the BBFC after 34 seconds of cuts with a PG rating on November the 17th of that year. The pre-cut cinema version of the film was later submitted twice for VHS classification, once in 1989 and again in 1995. Both submissions were passed PG without further cuts. The BBFC examiners at the time noted that the impact of the film's soundtrack was reduced when viewing the film on videotape on the small screen, without the more assaultive surround sound that had been present in the theatrical release, although the fight between Rozelle and Queen Bavmorda, which is rather tame today, was considered to be at the upper limits of the PG category. It would be a few more years before Willow was seen by the BBFC again, and in the summer of 2002, it was submitted by 20th Century Fox in its original uncut version for consideration for a special edition DVD release. With the passage of time, the board decreed that cuts were no longer required, and Willow was passed uncut with a PG rating in July 2002, with the BBFC noting that the film contains mild language, sex references, and fantasy violence. The uncut version of the film was later repackaged and re-released in 2013 on DVD and Blu-ray, and is now the standard version available to British consumers, with the cut version of the film banished to the netherworld where it belongs.